Have you seen this in your ClinCheck? I mean, the teeth move, spaces are created between the teeth, nothing touches anymore, and suddenly, bam, a big jump, and everything's in occlusion. There's a lot of confusion about this, and I receive a lot of questions when I lecture live or from our online courses about this situation. So let's take a look at what it is exactly and why you see it, and sometimes why you don't. In this video, let's be clear about the bite jump. Hi, I'm Stephane Reinhardt, director of the Education for the Clear Institute, where we provide education on clear aligners for dentists. Now, there's a lot of confusion in general about virtual setups when it comes to clear aligners. And it doesn't matter what type of aligners you're using or what brand. They usually all have their software that you will access to create your treatment plan. Now, if you use Invisalign aligners, the software is called the ClinCheck. But basically what you're seeing on the screen, it's always the same thing with all the systems. We think we are seeing teeth that are moving, and it's fun to watch this little cartoon. But that's not it. Not at all. In a ClinCheck, a virtual setup, when you move something, when you make changes, you're not moving teeth. You're moving plastic. You're changing the shapes of the aligners. The shapes of all the aligners that you will receive. And I see it's completely different than seeing teeth that are moving. You need to make this paradigm shift here in your head. And I know it's counterintuitive because after more than two decades using clear aligners in my practice, after more than two decades looking at ClinChecks, I still get caught into it. I have to talk to myself, I have to remind myself that what I'm looking at on the screen is not teeth that are moving. It's how the aligner will be shaped. It's how the force will be applied on the teeth. So if we're looking at shapes of aligners, if we're looking at how the force will be applied, what does that mean? Well, if I look at a ClinCheck and I look at stage number 10, well, it tells me what the shape of a aligner 10 will be. It tells me how the force will be applied on the teeth at aligner 10. And I'm not saying this is easy to understand or to figure out. I mean, how long do you think it took me? I mean, you think it was easy for me? Really? Think again. But it can be understood. I did. I mean, this means you can also. So let's jump now into the ClinCheck. So you see, this is an anterior open bite case. And usually with anterior open bite cases, we have to determine first, is it a skeletal problem? Is it a dental problem? That's the first thing, or a combination of both. By the way, if you're looking for a great course on anterior open bite, we have an online course that is really complete with feedback we get from this course is just incredible. You have all the details here somewhere. You will find it. You will find it, I'm sure. So we have to figure out what the treatment planning will be. I mean, will we go with orthognatic surgery? I mean, let's it's always a possibility. Let's remove this for the purpose of the case here. So let's say the patient doesn't want any surgery and he wants to be treated with clear aligner. So knowing we're going to use clear aligners, then we're going to move the teeth. So what do we have to figure out? In a case like this, we have to figure out how we will treatment plan the case. Will we extrude the anterior teeth? Will we intrude the posterior teeth? Will we do a combination of both? This is treatment planning the case. This is thinking what is best for this patient. Now, for example, if you take pictures, I mean, we have to take pictures, you have to look at the pictures, and you see that the patient with that relation, you know, that anterior open bite, when the patient smiles, we already see a gummy smile. In a case like this, I mean, what would be the purpose of extruding anterior teeth? Increase the gummy smile? Maybe, just maybe that's not a good idea. And we know that these vertical movements, when they're pure, like translation movements, so we're doing intrusion, extrusion, those are among the most difficult movements to achieve with clear aligners? I mean, if, especially, again, if they are pure and not relative. Relative, pure, pure, relative. This is a subject, topic for another video. So by the way, if you want to make sure not to miss any of our videos, upcoming videos, please subscribe to this channel and click the little bell that will notify you every time we have a new video online. So in this case, as you can see here, if we look at the movement that we're doing, you see that we are combining movements. So everything at the same time, which is already a mistake. We're intruding the posterior teeth and we're extruding the anterior teeth. Extremely difficult. You have to stage your treatment. This is again, a subject for another video. Make sure you subscribe. But we should stage, I mean, if we're intruding the posterior teeth, everything else should be anchored. If we're extruding the anterior teeth, everything else should be anchored. And we do not move all the teeth at the same time. Of course, it gives you less aligners, but also less predictability. But again, remember, as we see the teeth moving like this, we're not moving the teeth. We're changing the shapes of the aligners. See how different it is. Now, this is why we can create some space in between the teeth. Now, of course, this is not what will happen in your patient's mouth. You will never see something like that where nothing touches. You see, it's like the maxilla is floating in space, and the patient is like, nothing touches. That will never happen. So the teeth are not touching on the screen, but those are not the teeth. You could watch this independently, you know, the upper arch and the lower arch. A ClinCheck is not an articulator. The only occlusion you can look at that makes sense on the ClinCheck is the initial occlusion, not the final occlusion. This is why you will often see, and the more the case is complex, the more you will see it, you will see what we call over-engineering. Some will say over-correction. Again, another subject for another video. But what it means is we exaggerate movements on the virtual setup because we know this is not how the teeth will move. So there's a difference between a ClinCheck and a reality check. What you see on the screen is not what you get. It's like looking at a bended orthodontic wire. I mean, it could be scary, but it doesn't mean that the teeth will follow 100% of what you're seeing, because there's always this third law of Newton. You know, remember, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So when the aligners are forcing on the teeth are forcing on the aligner. So you will never express 100% of the force that these little beautiful appliance will apply on the teeth, because a part of it is absorbed by the plastic. Now remember, these are stretchable. They're like fancy elastics. I know it's a lot and it's counterintuitive, but once you get it, once you understand, once you learn, the beauty of it is that you will never unlearn. That is the beauty of working with clear aligners. You don't need any special skills with your hands. I mean, it's all in there. You work mostly with your head. This is why it was so difficult for me. So there's a tool in the ClinCheck for bite correction visualization. And as you can see, when we go on that tool, we have different options. You can hide the bite correction visualization. You can look at the bite correction at the beginning of treatment, throughout the treatment, or at the end of the active treatment. And as you can see here, with the little check mark, this is what was chosen. So depending on what you will choose, you will see different scenarios happen. So what does that mean? I mean, compare this to what an oral surgeon would do before an orthognatic surgery. It's like you just want to see that if the bite makes sense once the teeth are together. Because again, look at this. It's impossible. What we're seeing here is impossible. The teeth will never be like that. There will always be a contact between the teeth. So this is what number 13.
13, I should say, not 13, but 13, number 13.
This is what it means. And if you look here, you see these little diagonal lines like this. This means there's going to be a jump bite. This is what we see, a jump bite. This is why when I will go there, you will see the teeth bang, come together like this. So let's try it. 3, 2, 1, go. This is what you're seeing, the bite jump. But of course, what it means in reality is make sure you do not forget aligner number 13. A joke, of course. Doesn't change anything. It's just a visualization of how the jaws would fit together if it would move like this. So again, go back to the surgeons. They want workup models before they do the surgery to make sure that everything will fit well. It's the same thing that we can do here on the ClinCheck to give us an idea of would it fit great if the teeth would move like that. So what will happen if we try to look at the jump at the beginning of treatment? Try to think about it. Try to visualize it. So what would that mean? If we put the jump at the beginning, will we see something kind of weird? So let's try it just for fun. So let's change this. Let's go into bite correction visualization and let's put it at the beginning of treatment. Now we're here. Let's put it at the beginning, see what it does. So if we look here at the occlusion, the teeth are entering the others. It's like, look at this. It's like a fusion of the upper and the lower teeth. Of course, why? Because it takes the final position of the jaws with the initial position of the teeth. So this is why the teeth are entering inside one. This is why I'm telling you, this is not the reality. This is not the reality. So if we go there, look at how the teeth are entering. And then as we move, see we're changing and there's no jump at the end. The other option is we can have the bite correction throughout treatment, which would mimic more what should happen during the treatment. And sometimes we work with class 2 patients, class 3 patients. We use class 2 elastics, class 3 elastics. You will have the same thing. You can have some bite correction visualization. And if you have it throughout treatment, doesn't mean everything will move like that, but it gives you a better idea and it removes that jump that you can have at the beginning or at the end. And you could decide also not to have and to hide the bite correction completely. That way, there's no jump and teeth are never touching. And this is where it gets, again, confusing. So again, this is an idea of what it could be, not what it will be actually. Remember, you are moving plastic, not teeth. I will repeat it again and again and again and again. Is that less confusing now? I know you get it now. And this is what the jump bite is. And again, if you want, you can remove it completely. But why would you do that? Even if we know it's not how the teeth will move, we still want to see a good occlusion on the screen. We have an idea of how it can fit together at the end. It's shapes of aligners, but it's also a scan of the teeth. I know, still confusing, but I hope it makes more sense now for you. Now remember to subscribe to the channel and click that bell. And if you like this video and you want more, click that little thumbs up because it motivates us to do more and it helps this algorithm reach to other dentists like you who are interested in this kind of thing. This is everything I had for you in this video. Have fun with your bite jumps and have fun making the move. Don't forget to look at our website if you want excellent clear aligner education. Doesn't matter what level you are. We have everything for those who are beginning, those who are intermediate, advanced level, everything you need to become a master of clear aligners. And look at these other videos. I think they should interest you as well.